I like her style. Mm-hmm. I like her sound. I like her. Jamaican-born singer and songwriter Naomi Cowan is number one on the U.S. reggae charts with her single Paradise Plum.
And she's also the daughter of Jamaican music legend Charlene Davis.
Carlene,
thank you. And Sergio, Tommy Cowan. So Naomi's joining us this morning on the couch here. We're good to have you
here. Good morning. Thank you for having me. Excited to be here.
You feel like you have big shoes to fill when you have a legacy?
You know what? It doesn't feel like big shoes. It more feels like just a big privilege because the work they've done over the years is, I mean, like nothing else I've ever seen. And the fact that they're still doing what they love is phenomenal. They've been in the reggae music industry for over 30 years, right? So it's just a privilege. It's a privilege.
Plus, you're working with your dad, right? Hasn't he helped, like, produce some of your songs and stuff like that?
Yeah, well, I've been working with, you know, younger, fresher producers.
Okay, fine. Don't tell your father that.
No.
But he has worked on a song with you.
Yeah, and they just helped me with my direction in terms of what makes a hit song a hit song. There are some principles to music that you can never put aside.
Tell us about those principles.
So, for example, you want something that people can relate to. You want something as simple that a child can understand. You know, you want a melody that's catchy. Mm. You want stories that everyone can relate to. Those little things make hit songs, you know, where you repeat certain phrases. Like in my song Paradise Plum, I actually didn't have Paradise Plum in the chorus until my mom heard what I wrote. And she's like, no, man. You have to put Paradise Plum in the chorus. And so we rewrote the hook to include it. And that's where people, you know, so it was...
Or like the reinforcement?
The reinforcement of the message.
And the experience. I mean, you got to listen to your parents. Now, I know at one point you left Jamaica, you went to Canada. Mm-hmm. Was it because it got too cold there? You went back to Jamaica?
You know what? It was for the music. It was for reggae music.
Really? So Canada has a big reggae...
I came back to Jamaica after Canada for reggae music. I mean, mm-hmm. I went to Toronto for university. I'm also Canadian. So it was just a great place to live. Such diversity, great culture, people. I studied television, actually.
You guys are my dream.
So we can...
A business watch show, right?
Yes, I used to work on business television in Jamaica.
So do you want to, like, practice right now?
Sure.
What would you like to say, Naomi?
So this camera's live, right? So just going to make this up, right?
Okay, go for it.
This morning here on a good day, New York, we'd like to report that it's still very, very, very cold, but everyone looks fabulous because we're in New York.
All right.
Okay, so that was
me making it
musician friendly, right?
Yeah. Right, no, it was great. But think of some of the collaborations. Weren't you working with a band member from Magic?
Yes, his name is Mark Pelly.
Yes,
Mark is awesome.
I love that song that they're known for.
Yeah, why you gotta be so rude?
So
Mark and I connected in Toronto. He's also from Toronto. And a friend of mine was like, yo, if you're gonna do reggae music, you need to meet Mark. Long story short, we connected. And I said, Mark, you know, if we did a song together, I would love for us to do something meaningful. So we actually pulled from my dad's catalog, a song that was written in 1967, and we redid it.
Which song was it's that?
It's called Things You Say You Love.
And sing a little bit for us.
Sure. Things you say you love, you're gonna lose. And UB40 actually covered the song
too.
So we were just like, let's reinforce this melody, let's bring it back. And for the rocksteady reggae community, people loved it. You know, people that truly love the genre, and it was awesome.
You have a big event coming up, right, in Brooklyn?
Yes, I do have an event.
Tell us about that.
Yes, on Saturday at Lovers Rock, which is in Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn, and it's called Hold Tight. So it's a new series of events that happens monthly, and what they're trying to do is fuse the cool side of reggae with the fun dance hall side of Jamaican music. So they want people to be able to come but dance together. Oftentimes dance hall and reggae are separated, but this event kind of brings it together. So I'm kind of like a special guest. So in the middle of the party, I'll just get on the mic, you know, sing a little bit, sing Paradise Plum, and then we'll just party for the whole night. So it's more of a party, but they do this in the reggae scene where artists show up at smaller events, but it's a great way to connect with the community
of freestyle.
People. Yes, a lot of freestyling, you know, I try.
Do you need tickets? Or can you just show up at the
door?
You can
just show up. Yeah. So doors open 9:00. Lovers Rock, which is a really dope bar. I don't know when it opened, but it's a cool little Caribbean spot in the middle of Brooklyn. I love it.
Where do you make your home? In Jamaica?
So far, yes.
Okay, but you're here in New York frequently,
yes,
right?
Yes, I am.
And love the vibe. What is it that brings you here?
To
if
New
you're
York?
Not performing, but just to be here.
The energy, for sure, and the creativity, because it's so big and you realize you're just a speck. You know, I come from an island, so sometimes you can feel like a big fish in a small pond. But I love coming to larger cities just because you see so many people. And I people watch. I go to coffee shops.
Do you really?
And I'm like, oh, what is this person dreaming about? I wonder what their big dream is. And those little corners. And I just love going to smaller spaces in bigger places. Hey, that rhymed. and experiencing culture. That's what I love about New York.
Well, we've been to Jamaica, and I have to say, I love people watching there, too.
Yes.
I mean, everybody's so nice. And the water is the most gorgeous water I've
really
ever
is.
Seen. Does it ever get old?
No, it doesn't. There are still some places I've never experienced and been to on the island of Jamaica. And, you know, me and my friends, we tried to do adventures to just go to waterfalls and just check out non-touristy things.
That sounds
and
pretty awesome.
I go to Negril, to Rick's Cafe.
Oh, that's, have you jumped?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, look at you, Lori.
Wow.
I was a lot younger, but
See, it's just, you just need to do it once. Don't try and be a hero. My thing is, as long as you do it once,
I'm sure rum was involved.
Exactly.
So where can people find you?
Yes, so on Instagram, I'm Naomi Cowan. You were asking me earlier. And then on Twitter, I'm Naomi Cowan. So pretty simple, N-A-O-M-I-C-O-W-A-N.
Well, it's nice to meet you in person.
Thank
All
you.
The best. And Saturday night, we're going to come check you out. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, check me out. I'll be singing Paradise Plum.
Gotta
everyone
go.
Should check out the video as well, the visual. It's a candy-colored fantasy. So.
And we can dance. There's no restrictions on the dancing.
No restrictions.
Right.
Nice to
All right,
see you.
Thank you so much.